Hey, it's Michael J., and today I'm going to talk about one of my favorite character actresses, Martha Raye. Now, I think I first came in contact with Martha Raye from the television show The Bugaloos, a Sid and Marty Krofft television show where these kids in the 60s are dressed up like bugs and the villainess is Martha Raye. And at the same time I was seeing this, there was a movie on TV, Jumbo, which is 1961 from MGM, and Doris Day and Jimmy Durante are in it, and Martha Raye is in it. And so I was sort of aware of her based on that. And then she had this commercial series that she did, these commercials of dentures, and she'd say, take it from a big mouth. And so that's how I knew her. So as the years went on and I started seeing more films and she would pop up, I would just really enjoy her. And I found out later she was a recording artist and had made records and sung with big bands, and she was one of the Dollies in the original production of Hello Dolly. So I really started to like her a lot. And so here's my tribute to Martha Raye.
Born with the name Margie Reed to vaudevillians Reed and Hooper, Martha Raye grew up in Butte, Montana. Martha first appeared in the act at age 3, and later with a younger brother, Bud. The kids were so successful that the name of the act was changed to Margie and Bud. After outgrowing the kid act, Raye joined the Paul Ash Band as vocalist and also sang with the Boris Morris Orchestra in the early 1930s. She was picked up by Paramount Pictures in 1936 and made her feature film debut alongside Bing Crosby in Rhythm on the Range.
In the cowboy band, you should hear us make them with a honey
hole. You should hear us make with below.
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 Below. They both join in with the ho-ho-ho.
Yippee-yo. 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 Yippee-yo.
During the second half of the 1930s, Raye was also appearing on the radio with Al Jolson's weekly show.
I'm so very diggy-diggy-doo by nature. If you don't say diggy-diggy-doo, you'll make sure. Gonna lose your mama.
Go let those funny people smile.
In the movies and radio, Raye was paired up with some of the greatest comedians of the day. Joe E. Brown, Bob Hope, W.C. Fields, Abbott and Costello, Jimmy Durante, and Charlie Chaplin.
Now what are you doing?
I'm putting a worm on the hook.
A worm?
Of course.
Disgusting. You don't expect me to eat fish that's been eating worms, do you?
Very well, my dear. We'll fish without them.
Good.
During World War II, she toured with the U.S.O. to entertain the troops, and she continued to do this whenever she was needed throughout the rest of her life.
Watch the birdie, just crack a funny pose a while. Watch the birdie, or you can beat that pose a mile. Watch the birdie, now let me see a pretty spot and hold it. We're looking for a tall, dark, handsome man with eyes of blue, a golden tan, strong white teeth like Joe McRae. Hey, you!
We'll take a can of camera shot.
Watch the birdie.
Come on and give it all you got.
Watch the birdie.
Just look around and pick a spot and hold it. Zoot it. Hold it.
Come on and watch the birdie.
Just crack a funny pose a while.
Watch the birdie.
Oh, you can beat that pose a while.
Watch the birdie.
Now let me see a pretty spot.
Hold it.
Part of her comedic persona was her oversized mouth, and she was nicknamed the Big Mouth. She even made fun of this in later years when she made commercials for Polydent Green.
So take it from a big mouth.
Try Polydent Green, get tough stains clean with extra strain.
Joe E. Brown, also known for his own big mouth, was lampooned alongside Raye in the Disney cartoon Mother Goose Goes Hollywood. She had her own TV show from 1954 to 1956.
Martha Raye. An hour and a half of comedy, music, and dance.
And now, the star of our show, Martha Raye.
Dear doggy.
Group
the art side of a group out there.
After her TV show came to an end, Martha Raye's fifth marriage broke up, and that, combined with some health problems, sent her into a depression, and she attempted suicide. With the help of good friends, she recovered and went back to work, stronger than ever.
Maybe Monday, or maybe not. Still, I'm sure to meet him one day. Maybe Tuesday will be my good news day. We'll build a little home just now from which I'll never. All else above, I'm waiting for the
I love her in the 1961 MGM musical Jumbo.
You and Pop embarrassed.
Let me see your palm.
Oh, Lou, that's for suckers.
Well, you know what Barnum always said. There's one born every second. Hey, you know what?
No, and don't tell me, because I don't believe it. Witchcraft. Any intelligent person. Wow, what?
Wow, wow.
You really see something?
Yeah, I see a man. He's tall, dark.
And handsome. You are such a faker. Did you ever see anyone short, fat, and ugly?
Yep, in the mirror.
She was one of the many famous ladies that passed through the original production of Hello, Dolly! On Broadway. In 1970, she took on the role of Benita Bazaar in the Sid and Marty Krofft TV series The Bugaloos. A silly show, but I enjoyed it as a kid.
And the buggy bulls, the buggy bulls, 'cause I'm a nature girl, a nature girl. I ain't never going home.
Through the rest of the 1970s, she was a popular guest star on many TV shows.
Are you kidding? Ain't any $200 bucks worth. You ain't lost that.
You can't. You gotta go down and have them fitted. You can't send no.
Are you kidding? There ain't $200 worth of life in you. I got it.
Bye.
Watch it. Watch it. Watch it, baby. You're cutting my beer. Is that your kid?
Yes.
You married?
I beg your pardon. What kind of a person do you think I am?
Look, lady, this is Central Park. For all I know, you could be a cop in drag. You see, in drag, you start... All right.
Yes? No. For all the fun and joy she gave the public, her personal life was always a struggle. She was married seven times altogether.
Ah, kitten, don't you ever think of getting married? Huh?
Not more than three or four times a day.
With me, it's on the hour.
The last marriage in 1991 was only ended by her death in 1994. She suffered from cardiovascular disease and Alzheimer's and actually died of pneumonia. All this while also having her home destroyed in the 1994 Northridge earthquake.
Ain't gaining any ground, 'cause my angel eyes ain't here. So drink up all you people.
Besides being named an honorary colonel in the U.S. Marines and an honorary lieutenant colonel in the U.S. Army for her work with the U.S.O., Raye was also honored with the Jean Hersholt Humanitarian
Myself,
Award.
I promise you I shall try for the rest of my life to really deserve and be worthy of this magnificent honor bestowed upon me. God bless you and thank you.
She was also honored with the Presidential Medal of Freedom.
Honor Guard, present.
Martha Raye, what a character.
Come on and give it all you got. Watch the birdie. Just watch the birdie. Pick a spot and hold it.